Hey, everybody. This is Matt Damon. So a few years ago, a bunch of us did this movie called Contagion, which we've noticed is creeping its way back up on the charts on iTunes for obvious reasons, given what we're all living through right now. And so the Mailman School of Public Health at Columbia University reached out to the cast and asked us if we would have a virtual reunion to do some PSAs for everybody that might be helpful. And so we readily agreed, and so here they are. So everything you're gonna hear from us has been vetted by public health experts and scientists. So I'm here to talk to you about social distancing, something we've been hearing a lot about on TV, I think, the last couple weeks. In the movie, I played a guy who was immune to the hypothetical virus that was spreading around the world. And so a few things to start. One, that was a movie. This is real life. I have no reason to believe that I'm immune to COVID-19, and neither do you, no matter how young you are. This is a new virus. It's going to take some time for our bodies and our doctors to understand it and to understand the best way to protect us. So new viruses emerge all the time. This isn't the first, and it won't be the last. So the good news is we have seen things like this before, and we emerge stronger as a result. And in time, we're going to win against this one as well. How much time? That is an excellent question. Nobody knows for sure, but we do know how to make that day get here quicker. And that's what I'm here to talk to you about. Social distancing. It means stay 6 feet away from another person. It means not gathering in groups, and it means staying home or sheltering in place if that's what government officials are telling you to do. People can have COVID-19 and have very mild symptoms or no symptoms at all. So even if you think that they're healthy or you think that you're healthy, don't take that chance. It is not worth it. Every time that you pass this virus to someone else, you are actually giving it to 3 or 4 other people as well, and then those people are going to do the same. So before long, that one person turns into hundreds, turns into thousands, and that's how we got into this situation in the first place. Now, if you are young and healthy, you might think that this is no big deal because you've heard that this virus is nothing more than a bad cold for you. And that is not true, spring breakers, okay? Almost 40% of the people hospitalized in this pandemic are under 55. And if you know anybody over the age of 55 or anyone who has any kind of pre-existing conditions, this is a lot more serious for them. So you can literally save their life just by staying away from each other. You can actually sit on the couch or in a chair like I'm doing and watch TV and save a life at the same time. You can work from home, you can use social media to communicate, you can save a few more. Now is the time to spend all the time you want staring at your phone or your tablet. And if anybody gives you a hard time about it, tell them not to bother you because you are saving lives. Just make sure that you tell them that from 6 feet away. We can all do this together just by staying apart. Please do your part. Other generations have been asked to do extraordinary things. We're being asked to just stay at home. We got this. Please, let's respect and protect our elders. Thanks, everybody.
In the movie Contagion, I played a scientist who helped discover a vaccine for a hypothetical virus. But COVID-19 is very real, and it is spreading all over our planet every day. The scientists who helped me prepare for that movie want us all to know some things that will help keep us safe. First, this is not a Chinese virus or a virus that has no effect on the young and healthy. It is what they call a novel virus, and that means our immune systems have never seen it before. So until we have a treatment or a vaccine, every single one of us, regardless of age or ethnicity, is at risk of getting it. So if you're anything like me, your first question is, how long will a vaccine take? Scientists say anywhere from 16 to 18 months, and scientists and doctors are the people we need to be listening to right now. They are the experts, and that means tuning out the voices with other agendas, no matter how powerful they might be. So why does it take so long? A vaccine is a tool that teaches our immune system to attack a disease before it makes us sick. It works by safely exposing our immune system to a small part of the virus. Doing that allows our body to manufacture antibodies and other cells that kill the virus and keep us healthy. As it turns out, designing the vaccine is the easy part, but it is critical that a vaccine is safe and effective, otherwise it can make matters worse. And that means it needs to be tested to make sure it works exactly the way we need it to, and that takes time. Over the course of history, science has come up with vaccines for polio and smallpox and other diseases that can be far more serious than COVID-19. And there was a time, not that long ago, when polio terrified people in America and smallpox killed people everywhere. But now, both have all but vanished from the globe, mainly because of vaccines. I'm not a scientist, I'm an actor, I'm also a daughter, a wife, and a mother. I realize that this virus is a threat to all of us, and so I am hoping we can learn not to be a threat to each other. Science is based on evidence, on doing tests over and over again, and getting the same results. Paranoia is a kind of virus as well. It requires fear and misinformation to spread, and we don't need scientists to cure that, just compassion and common sense. So until we have a vaccine or a cure, we need to be that for each other. We can do that by listening to the public health officials where we live, observe social distancing, washing our hands often, and we can get through this together just by staying apart. To stay informed, stay healthy, stay home. In the movie Contagion, I played an epidemiologist trying to stop the spread of a hypothetical virus. To prepare for the role, I spent time with some of the best public health professionals in the world. And what was one of the most important things they taught me? Wash your hands like your life depends on it. Because right now, in particular, it just might. Or the life of someone you love, or even the life of someone you might not know, but is still deserving of your consideration. Like the people on the front lines of this fight right now, the doctors and the healthcare providers, the people who are still working in the grocery stores or delivering food to your homes, which is where you should be right now. So if you're feeling overwhelmed, a little bit powerless at the moment, here's something that we can all do to make a difference, and it doesn't require a medical degree or a microscope or a ton of knowledge. Soap and water are all you need. Just get the temperature right. The water doesn't need to be that hot, and most any soap will do. The way soap works is that one end of the soap molecule binds with the water, and the other end binds to the grease on your hands. The virus is washed away with that grease when the soap molecule attaches to it. Yep, yeah, a scientist taught me that. Why else would I know it? They also taught me to wash my hands for 20 seconds, which is roughly how long this segment has taken. 3, 2, 1. Remember that there is only one way to get COVID-19. If you come in direct contact with a droplet from the cough or a sneeze of an infected person, and that droplet finds its way into your eyes, nose, or mouth. Gross but true, that's why people need to cover their mouths like this, because COVID-19 can also live on surfaces, or as scientists call them, fomites, because the lovely scientists do like to have special words for everything. Fomites include everything from cardboard boxes that you might receive your vitamin supplies, your pet food, or even your baby milk formula, to stainless steel forks, to carpeting and bedding and clothes. Depending on the surface, COVID-19 can live there from a few hours to a few days. So wipe down surfaces that are frequently used with a disinfectant. And here are the rules for that. Spray. Wait 4 minutes and then wipe. Yes, it takes 4 minutes for a disinfectant to do its job. And avoid touching your face. It's not easy, but it's an important one. Because if you touch a surface with your hands and then you touch your face, you can get infected. So to put it bluntly, the health of our society is quite literally in your hands. I know this is hard and this is new and it's scary, but you really can defend yourself and the people you love with a bar of soap
a sink, some water, and by listening to the public health experts where you live. We all want a cure, but until we have one, we need to be that for each other, starting now.
Hi, I'm Laurence Fishburne. In the movie Contagion, I played a doctor at the Center for Disease Control. The virus in that movie was created by a screenwriter. COVID-19 is very real. Most of us aren't old enough to remember the diseases smallpox and polio and the way that those diseases had affected billions of lives. But they changed the way that people lived. And it looks like COVID-19 is forcing us to change the way that we live, at least for a while. Now, there's a scene in the movie Contagion about the tradition of handshaking. You extended your hand and showed the person you were meeting that you didn't have a weapon, that you weren't carrying one. Well, now the way we're living is like we're all carrying a weapon and we don't even know it. What we do know is that the virus travels through human contact. That's one of the ways it travels. It needs us to survive. So let's not give it any help. Quite simply, one of the best ways to prevent yourself from getting COVID-19 is by behaving like you already have it, which means social distancing. Stay at home if it's at all possible for you. Wash your hands often, like it's your job. Listen to your public health officials wherever it is that you happen to live. A pandemic means that the virus is everywhere, but it won't be every place at the same time. So if it's not where you live today, you can bet that that's going to change. And if you don't know anyone who's sick yet, you can also bet that that will change as well. Our public health experts are telling us that the virus could affect as many as half of us in the coming months moving forward. And that would mean that you or I or someone very close to us will contract the disease, will contract the virus. We need to do everything possible, everything that we can to prevent that from happening. If we can slow this thing down, it will give our doctors and our nurses in our hospitals a fighting chance to help us all get through this thing together. Everything that you can do to stay healthy, everything that I can do to stay healthy, everything that we can do to stay healthy will keep our people on the front lines from getting sick, and that is so important. And I know it's frightening to wake up every day and to see on the news that more people have died, but the overwhelming majority of us are going to live. Every day, the number of those who are being cured will increase, and our scientists can learn from how their immune systems defeated the virus and discover treatments until we have a vaccine. So until we have a cure, you can be that for the people where you live and for the people that you love. We can beat this thing together just by staying apart. Thanks a lot. Bless you. Stay healthy. Stay safe.